Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. Hi, welcome to another lecture from Robojax. In this lecture, we are going to see how we can use this LM35 temperature sensor and display the temperature as Celsius, Fahrenheit, and Kelvin on the LCD1602 or LCD2004. I have a separate video introducing this LM35 with full detail and specification on how to use it. And I have also a separate video showing how to use this LCD1602 or 2004 with just 4 wire because it has this I2C module. So make sure to use this separately, download the library, and make sure that you are able to display a text on this. After that, then run the code for this and make sure that you are able to read the temperature and display it on the serial monitor. After that, we are combining this together. And here's the wiring diagram for LM35. The left pin is VCC. I've connected it to pin 2, where we have defined it inside the code as extra 5 volts. The middle pin is output. It has been connected to analog 0. The right pin is ground. It has been connected to one of the grounds. The LCD monitor, I've flipped it on the other way, so based on the label, ground is connected to the ground, VCC is connected to 5 volts, SDA has been connected to analog 4, SCL has been connected to analog 5. You can also connect it to the last two pins here that are labeled as SDA and SCL. Now let me explain the wiring. The left pin of LM35 is connected to pin 2, where we have defined it as extra 5 volts inside the code. You can change and you can select any other pin you want. The middle pin is the output. Using green wire, it has been connected to analog 0. And the right pin is the ground. It has been connected to the ground. For the LCD module, we have 4 wires. Left pin from this side, it is ground. It has been connected to ground of Arduino. The second pin is VCC. It has been connected using white wire to 5 volts. Then we have SDA, using gray wire, have been connected to analog 4, and SCL is connected, the last pin, using this purple wire to analog 5. You can also connect it to this SDA and SCL accordingly. Now let me explain the code. We are defining analog 0 as an input pin. And then we are defining pin 2 for extra VCC for LM35 because we have only 1 5 volts and I did not want to use a breadboard. And then this 1000 iteration is for the same as the introduction video, which takes 1000 measurement and gets the average. And this LM35 factor is the 10 millivolts per degree Celsius. Do not change it. This portion is for LCD screen. This is the class of a library, and we are taking the class, creating an object called LCD, and this is the I2C address. The address for this module, we are passing it, and if you don't know it, here is how you do it. You find it. I will provide you the code with I2C scanner. This is the code I will provide you. Just put it in a sketch, upload it to the module, to your Arduino, and then open the serial monitor. Then you will read it. If the wiring, everything is okay, you will be able to see the I2C address, and it will continuously print that for you. So that is 0.26. That is why I'm using that, and 16 means 16 character, and 2 means 2 line, because here we have 1, 2, 3, up to 16 characters, and we have 2 lines. And that is this symbol here, either as Kelvin, Celsius, or Fahrenheit. And I've given it 2 seconds before printing Fahrenheit. At the same way, this is the temperature, this is the symbol. and you must pass it inside a single code with capital C, capital F for Fahrenheit and capital K for Kelvin. And if you want to take some action based on temperature, so this is giving you the temperature in Celsius, and you want to say F, the temperature is greater than 87 degrees, do something. So this is the opening and closing for the condition, and whatever action you want to take, put it in here, like turning on a relay or fan or something, so you can do the action here. The rest of the code is exactly the same as the main introduction to LM35, with the exception that I've added this function here, LCD display float. We are getting the value, we are passing two values, the temperature and the character. Then we have this for loop, which goes from I equals 7 to 16. The reason for 7 is that we already have the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. From 7, from this point, we want to clear this out every time everything else is written. The top and this portion is always here. We are not refreshing it. We are just refreshing this portion. So we set the character I, whatever is I, 7, 8, 9, 10, up to 16, up to 15. And then one mean line one. So we go to this line, set the cursor, and when we print 254, that is printing a blank space, which means clearing the character. And then we set the character again to character 7. And then line one, we print the value, the temperature. And this one prints 223, means the circle, the degree symbol of type character. After that, we print F. That F that comes at the end is printing like this, LCD print F. And then F, now we want to print K. If the symbol is equal K, we print K. And if the symbol is, otherwise it is C, so we'll print the C at the end in here. Now let me demonstrate it. Now this is showing the room temperature, and I'm using this heat gun to apply some heat on this. So the temperature is increasing. As you can see, it shows 55. And now it will cool down slowly, 83 degrees, and slowing down. Perfectly working. Currently it is connected to 5 volts, but let me connect it to 3.3 volts and see if it works. So when I remove it, it will read incorrect value or zero. So now I'm connecting it to 3.3 volts, and let's see what we are reading. So still it's working, but the manufacturer suggests it should be connected to minimum of 4 volts. But still, we are reading value. I don't know how accurate it is when you connect it in 3.3 volts. For that reason, connect it to 5 volts. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this LM35 with LCD1602. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos. Hi, welcome to an Arduino lecture from Robojax. In this lecture, we are going to learn how we can use this K-type thermocouple with MAX6675 to control a load as a heater or cooler, so we can turn it on and off and keep the temperature in certain range, either as a cooler or as a heater. Cannot have a one number. For that reason, I put 80 and 100. I put them apart because the demonstration will be easy, but for real, now let me apply heat.